Good evening. We start tonight with an exclusive Care 11 investigation. One of the leaders of a notorious religious group that preaches polygamy and marriages involving children has relocated to Minnesota, and records show he is buying land in a remote area near the North Shore.
As AJ Legault reports, he's the target of a new lawsuit involving the alleged sexual abuse of an 8-year-old child.
We've gotten reports that he's been living up here.
The search is on along rural roads in northern Minnesota for this man, Seth Jeffs, at one time a high-ranking leader of the Fundamentalist Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, a notorious polygamous sect from Utah known for child brides. Seth and other church leaders scattered after his brother, Warren Jeffs, was convicted and began serving a life sentence for sexually abusing young children.
So this is the complaint.
Now, Utah lawyer Alan Mortensen is searching for Seth Jeffs, trying to serve him with a lawsuit on behalf of a woman who says she was sexually assaulted for years, beginning when she was just 8 years old. The lawsuit claims Seth Jeffs is one of the church leaders who witnessed and helped arrange the religious sexual rituals with underage girls.
And he allowed it to happen, and he witnessed it happening over and over and over to a young girl.
The attorney has gotten a tip that he's been living at this cabin near Lutzen.
No one's home, unfortunately.
And not just living here, but buying property. These records obtained by Care 11 show a company Seth Jeffs represents recently purchased 40 acres of land.
Arrived.
It's located in a remote area between Lutzen and Grand Marais. When we went there recently, there was an entrance road, what looked like a bobcat, and a sign saying, "No trespassing."
If past behavior is indicative of future behavior, they would bring people to start a religious colony.
The Utah attorney didn't find Jeffs at either location, but using public records, Care 11 located another address here in the Twin Cities. Our cameras were there for the stakeout as Seth Jeffs was finally located.
Hello, Seth?
Yes.
Hey, got some documents for you.
Okay.
All right, thank you.
After the official legal papers were served, Care 11 tried to contact Seth Jeffs.
Mr. Jeffs, AJ Legault, I'm with Care 11 News. We'd like to talk with you.
But he refused to come to the door.
Now, we have spoken to a number of folks who live up on the North Shore. Their big concern was about the possibility of the religious sect establishing a compound up there. Now that Jeffs has been located, they're hoping the abuse lawsuit that you just saw him get served and a judgment in another case might allow the victims to seize that property and prevent any development.
I couldn't believe it when I saw this cross Twitter today. And then when you said it's Warren Jeffs' brother, and I mean, great information.
That's certainly a name lots of folks are going to recognize. Absolutely. He's serving life in prison for sexual abuse of young kids.
Much more to come on this story.
Absolutely.
Thank you, AJ.
Thanks, AJ.